Hi everyone! You ask me a lot how you can set up the lighting of a room when this room has no windows and so we can't place a sunlight. And my answer always is that lighting in V-Ray follows the same rules as lighting in real life. I still keep getting the same question, so I decided to make this short video so that you can see the steps you should follow. I have created this small VSE just for the purposes of this video. And let me go to the perspective view and orbit the viewport so that you can see that there are no openings in the room I modeled. And if I click on the render production button, here is the render I get. So you can see that even when we don't have any windows, even when there is no sunlight, you should be able to light up your scene with no issues. Let's now see the steps I followed. First, let me delete all the lights I have placed. Let me select the camera and go to its properties. So, as I mention in every video, I always set the exposure to exposure value and I start with a value of 13, but since the room has no openings, I will start with 6. If I do a render, I get a black image. And this happens because right now we do not have a single light source in the scene. As I said at the very beginning of this video, you should treat lighting in 3ds Max as you would if you would actually build this room. So, first off, I have placed 2 spotlights on the ceiling. Let me select those and isolate them. I will zoom in one of them, go to the command panel, to the create tab, choose lights, V-Ray and V-Ray Light. I will go to Type and choose Disk. I will go to the top viewport, click and drag to create the disk V-Ray Light. Then I will go to the front viewport and move the light to the correct position. Then, I will make an instance for the second spotlight. Let's end the isolation mode and do a render to see what we get. So, everything is really dark, but I start seeing the interior, so we are in a good direction. I will select one of the lights, since they are instances, go to its properties in the Modify tab, and increase the multiplier, which is the intensity of the light. So, instead of 30, I will type 120. This is brighter, but still pretty dark. When you add spotlights, please keep in mind that apart from placing a V-Ray light, which resembles, let's say, the light bulb, to also add a V-Ray IES light, which resembles the distribution of the light. So let me select one more time the 2 spotlights and isolate them. I will go to the command panel, select V-Ray IES, and go to the front viewport to place it. I will now go to the top viewport to move it to the correct position. And as before, I will create an instance for the second spotlight. Then I will select one of the 2 IES lights, go to its properties in the Modify tab, and load an IES file. If we now do a render, You see how clearly our interior now looks. We can control the intensity of the IES lights through the Modify tab and the intensity value. I will make this 2000 since I don't want to have a very strong lighting. And finally, in this bathroom, I also have hidden lights behind the WC wall. So let me select these two surfaces and isolate them. Go to the left viewport, choose V-Ray light, and draw a rectangle. Then I will go to the top viewport to reposition it. Finally, I will create an instance for the other side and mirror it. I will end the isolation and do one more render. Let me reduce the intensity of these lights. And we are all set. So you can see that even when there are no openings in a room, you shouldn't be having any issues to light up your scene. Simply put lights where you have light fixtures and then play with each light's intensity to reach to the desired result. Don't forget that you can also control the brightness of your render through the exposure layer. So I can come to the Layers tab, click on the Add Layer button and choose Exposure. And then slide to the left or to the right to make the necessary adjustments. Thanks for watching. I will see you all in my next video.